Sorry, we don't have printed programs. We're starting with a Mozart sonata in E minor, Herschel 304. It's in two movements. And then we'll be doing The Lark Ascending by Vaughan Williams, arranged for violin and piano. And then I will play a solo piece. It's the Paschalia by Leopold Godowsky, based on Schubert's Unfinished Symphony. And after that, we'll have a brief intermission, and continuing on with the Brahms Sonata Number 1 in G major, which is in three movements, Opus 78. And so, hope you enjoy the Mozart.
Thank you.
All right, so we'll be doing the Lark Ascending now by Ralph Vaughan Williams. This is usually done with violin and orchestra, but I was interested to read that it apparently was composed first for piano and violin, so the orchestra came later.
Thank you.
44 variations on it. with all kinds of different ideas interspersed on top of it. He actually includes one of Schubert's most famous songs, The Erl King. I'll just play that. So you'll hear that motif with the theme that I just played at the same time. Let me think. And then there's a short epilogue after these 44 variations, and then it's followed by a cadenza, which is essentially a dominant pedal point, which means it's just like one chord, and on top of that is all this filigree work. And some of the chords, I think, sound like Gershwin, almost Gershwin-esque. And then it's finished with a fugue on the same subject. But, so the fugue is, he gives you the theme in inversion. So instead of, you'll hear it flipped. And he puts it in canon, which means like you're playing it in a round. So it'd be like, kind of an ingenious piece, how he constructs it. But I also find it to be a very emotionally satisfying piece. And one last thing is, if you know the Schubert Unfinished Symphony, after this opening, which is very deep, like the bass is quiet and it's very soft, it goes into this very fateful theme, which is... And you'll hear that at the end. At the very end of the piece, he actually quotes that. And so I think it's a very satisfying ending, actually. Okay. Oh, you know, one other thing I wanted to mention. I think it's important to know Leopold Godowsky was one of the greatest pianists of all time, and he wasn't really known, well, he was known in his time, but I think his reputation is not what it should be because of his recorded legacy. He was very shy in front of the microphone, so his recordings don't really capture him in his prime. He's really famous for taking the Chopin Etudes, 24 studies, and he did 53 transcriptions of them, sometimes putting two together. Many of them are for left hand alone. So he was known for doing all kinds of like impossible tricks, you know, putting many voices together. He would take two etudes, the Black Key and the Butterfly. So he was like somebody who would do all these things. And famous pianists like Rachmaninoff, Joseph Hoffman, they would all go to his house and hear him do these amazing things, and they would say, never forget what you heard tonight, because he was at his best like in his salon, you know. He wasn't really comfortable in a big concert stage. And unfortunately, he had a stroke. And he didn't really play in public much after. He was in the middle of recording the Chopin Scherzi, so that was tragic. But really, only a pianistic genius could have composed this piece. I just wanted to point that out. So it's a pretty interesting work. Thank you. Just a few words about the Brahms. This sonata is titled The Reagan Lied. There's a song by Brahms that, well, it translates as the rain song. So you will hear, well, in general, it has kind of a pastoral atmospheric quality. But in the last movement, you'll hear these repeated notes that, to me, sound kind of like raindrops. It's a repeated figure. The first movement is more vivace, ma non troppo, so lively but not too much. He's very finicky about his tempo. The second movement is, I think it's just adagio. Just adagio, which is A's. And then the last movement is allegro molto moderato. So allegro, but very moderately. So he has these funny markings, you know, he'll write poco forte. We don't really know what that means. Calando, which means calm. Sostenuto, does it mean to slow down? Does it mean sustained? Nobody really knows the answer. He's very specific, and yet there's some sort of enigmatic quality to the markings.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. to come back next year.
Next year.
Thank you so much for coming, and I thank you all for coming here today.
Right.
And this concludes our spring season. We'll begin again in September, and mostly be outdoor concerts, and that's also there's no word for all this experience. I'm overwhelmed, and I thank you again for being here.
And let's hear it for Kai, who is all this.
Kai!
Richterarts.org.
Richterarts.org.
Well, let's hear it for Richard.
Richard!
That usually play on much, much bigger stages. It's, I mean, we heard the Long Sisters, and the pianos they usually play on, just right. Like Eric, are twice the size right. Of what fits into this room. They mainly do it thanks to the personal connections that Kai has Kai. And her charm, and she knows how to twist people.
I'm completely blessed with people and friends. This is how I get
that talent all around. You know, so many talented people.
Yes, I do. We're looking for a new piano, by the way. If anybody is interested in helping us to find another piano, what do you think, Eric?
Yeah.
Do you think this piano was?
Well, it's a little tired. It's a nice sound, but
it's a tired piano.
It's not a bad piano.
Sounded good to us.
The drums, the repeated notes, are kind of hard to navigate.
Yes, but you were amazing. You did
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.